Hello everyone, this is Faisal. Hope you are well and staying safe. If you look up at the moment, you'll see that we do have lights. My internet is working, the plug points are working. This is because Eskom is not load shedding at the moment. But this is not always the case because Eskom has been load shedding a lot recently due to generation capacity, and this affects a lot of people working from home because they don't have access to the internet, and the kids also get frustrated because they can't watch TV and your fridges and many other appliances in your home. So what is a lasting solution to the load shedding problem? Well, Eskom needs to get their ducks in a row. But as you heard President Ramaphosa speaking last week about independent power producers, this is going to take a while. What is the immediate short-term solution? Well, you can get yourself a generator, which I must admit is very, very noisy, and you do have breakdowns, and also it leaves a polluted atmosphere in your yard. So my solution is, and this is what I'm going to be doing, is getting an inverter. Now, this is absolutely amazing, guys, because the unit that I'm getting and the package that I'm getting can run a number of things in your home, and it lasts anywhere between 6 and 8 hours. So it is quite pricey, but it's an investment for the future in case there is load shedding. So let me show you what I did get. Okay, guys, so this is what I did get. I got a Mesa 2400 VA 1440 watt 24 volt inverter. This is basically the smart power source for home and office appliances. So this is the inverter. At the bottom of the shelf, you will see that I did get 2x Royal 105 AH 12 volt batteries. This is basically what is going to power all my devices and my lights and everything in the home. I'll tell you exactly what this whole system will power up. In the box here on the side, the ground box is basically a cabinet. Now, when built up, this cabinet will then hold these two batteries inside and the inverter on top, so it makes it look neat. And I'm going to take that cabinet and then put it underneath the shelf and use this power point or this plug point to actually power up the whole inverter system. And also, when there is lights, it will charge the batteries, and when there's load shedding, inverter will automatically kick in. So my inverter is set up. There's an electrician that connected it for me. If you look at the black plug there, there's a white wire attached to it, and it goes underneath the table here, and that goes all the way into the ceiling, and it's connected to my DB board. And then the power for the inverter is connected obviously to the socket there, and the inverter is switched on. Below the inverter is the cabinet I was talking about earlier. Now, in this cabinet is the two batteries. It's quite neat, it's in the cabinet, and it doesn't look unsightly. And if you look here at the bottom, it does have wheels, so you can actually push it around. So the batteries are in this cabinet and the inverter on top of the battery cabinet. So it looks neat, and I've got a little place in this corner where I've put it, which is in my closet. So if you look at the screen, there's an input of about 227 VAC and the output is 227 VAC. So basically at the moment we don't have load shedding. So what is happening is that my lights and my power at home is running off normal Eskom or city power electricity. When the power goes out, or if there's load shedding, this will then have 0 bars and you'll have a solid bar here. So let's test it out and check how it works. Okay, so I'm going to tell Amara now to switch off the main switch on my DB board. Amara, switch off the mains. As you can see, that there is no power now coming from city power, and I'm running completely off battery. So you can see that the output is now on battery, and that the inverter is now powering my entire household. Amara, switch on the mains. Okay, Amara has switched on the mains. and now I'm running off normal electricity from city power. But you hear a sound coming from the inverter. That's because the battery is now charging because it was running off battery power for a few minutes. But this sound stops after the battery is fully charged. So this is a solution to the current load shedding problems we have in and around the country. And this is a good solution because it really does a lot. Okay guys, so that is the setup I have in my home to combat the load shedding and the loss of power from the power utility. Obviously, a lot of people will want a bigger setup, a more expensive setup, but it all depends on your finances and what you actually need. Now, I just want to give you the details of what my setup will power. In my case, I wanted certain things to be on when we do lose power. So this setup can run my entire home's lights. It runs my TV, it runs my decoder, it runs my modem, my Wi-Fi, my laptop, my desktop, portable and cell phone charging. Now to put that into perspective, let me give you an idea. So my entire home's lights are on. My bedroom's one plug is on. That is where my fiber is connected to. Also my lounge's plugs are on, which will then power the router, my TV, my decoders, and all my other appliances in the lounge. And then now in my office as well, my office lights and the plugs in my office will also be powered up by the inverter. So you can do a lot and you can ensure that you're not affected by the power outage, whether it's load shedding or any other incident that may occur, which may result in a loss of power. So how long does it last? Well, depending on usage, the inverter can power your house from anywhere up to 6 to 8 hours. And I think that may be sufficient time for the power utility to then return power as far as load shedding is concerned. Anyway guys, hope you enjoyed the video. Don't forget to hit the like button and also subscribe to the channel. And check out my channel for other videos of reviews that I've done. And remember to share the video as well. Until next time, please do take care of yourself and each other. Stay safe. Peace.